Welcome to the third edition of our webinar, News is Undervalued, brought to you in partnership with ABP News. In these times of crisis, our dependency on news has increased by many folds. Also, in last 8 weeks of lockdown, news perhaps is the only medium that, despite so many challenges, is able to create fresh content. Also, it is the only genre that is managing to pull off the business to some extent. To discuss this and more on news, we have with us Ms. Vaishali Verma, CEO Initiative. Welcome to the webinar, Vaishali.
Thank you so much, Nazia. Thanks a lot.
This was long due. I mean, I've been wanting to do an interview with you for a very, very long time.
Yeah. Somehow, always a pleasure to talk to you.
It won't work out. So, Vaishali, you're in the business of agency. You're handling so many clients. And there is so much drop in ads these days. But there's one genre, like what I've been hearing from most of the people around me, is that most of the inventory these days is going into news, right? Because that's the viewership is almost like 200% more. So would you want to speak more about it?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I think what this lockdown has done to us, the positive side of it for us in the media industry is that there is unprecedented increase in time spent on television, overall time spent on television or digital. And most of the genres have grown during this time, during the COVID times. But yes, news has seen an unprecedented growth, I think almost 200 to 300%. And that is obvious at the back of, you know, the entire anxiety which the consumers or, you know, our viewers are going through. There's so much to know. And I think news channels are doing a great job in shouldering that responsibility and the way, you know, they are going about guiding our consumers or viewers in terms of the precaution and how to remain calm in the alarming situation. And awareness is the only way which, you know, one can handle this outbreak, or this outbreak can be beaten. And one of the most effective ways to spread awareness is through television. I mean, which is a bigger medium than television to reach Indian households. And news, of course, is at the realm of it, given the entire newsiness of the environment which is around us. So yes, it has grown exponentially. However, we know that, you know, advertising has got impacted. There are certain sectors like automobiles or consumer goods or handset, etc., at the back of supply chain hit and retail shutdown. A lot of sectors have got impacted. So I think what is happening is, while news has grown exponentially, maybe they have not got, you know, the return on in terms of the advertising revenue. Or let me tell you that the growth is there, but it's not proportionate to the increase in their advertising revenue, because sadly, not all sectors are advertising, and there are CPGs, which is the FMCG sectors are on. There are a lot of healthcare sectors, which is on education, yes. And there are a lot of social welfare and the government, you know, led initiatives, which is keeping the momentum on. But sadly, yes, the inventory or, you know, the demand is not as much, which is kind of, you know, disproportionate to when you, if you are on the other side of the table. I can totally understand the frustration as well.
But that is true for all the genres. So for the viewers who are joining us now, because I think I started 2 minutes ahead, I must repeat that we are debating, we have a panel on is news undervalued, and the topic that we are speaking on today is that is the news generation the genre next, because that's the only genre which has shown growth in last few weeks of lockdown. It has grown almost by 200 to 300%. It is the only genre which is keeping the business on. So with us we have Vaishali Verma, who's speaking today on what is the future of news, which has come out as kind of a hero of the lockdown period in genres. So Vaishali, you've already given us an insight on how important news is and how much growth it has shown. But do you also believe that it's been undervalued all throughout?
See, it is undervalued, and I'll tell you the reason why. You know, there are two reasons. One is, news has to shift from its dependence on events And traditionally, whenever there's election or it could be a Pulwama news coverage, Babri Masjid verdict, or a Trump visit, we see unprecedented increase in viewership, right? And those are the times when the new genre are able to attract that premium, even in terms of advertising revenue, you know. But they cannot be dependent on what's bad or what's good. You know, it is news is a window to the world, and they need to have a constant engagement with the consumer or the viewer, which needs to be there. Because what happens is when you don't have these events happening, then suddenly there is a drop. And when you don't see the eyeballs happening as much as you want it from for it to attract the advertising revenue, obviously it's difficult to sustain. So that's one reason. And the other is also there's so much of focus on, you know, breaking news, who broke first, wherein the consumer is focusing on what is credible. So there's always, I feel, and that's a very personal view, that it's always there's always a mismatch between speed and credibility. You know, the news channel why a lot on breaking it first, vis-a-vis then kind of sustaining it. But having said that, I still strongly feel that if they have a strong engagement content which is sustainable, which keeps the momentum on even beyond these events, they will definitely be valued more. Because see, what are advertising paying for? Advertisers are paying for consumer's eyeball, and wherever the consumer eyeball moves, the advertisers will be there. And it's, and of course they are fairly frugal, and in nowadays it's everybody is very cautious of whatever they are spending, and it's very ROI driven. But if they see those eyeballs being sustained, I mean currently we are seeing the 200% jump, and I hope to see this momentum even post the recovery phase, you know. So as we are seeing that there was an outbreak, there's a recovery phase, and then there will be a stabilization phase, right? Because this will not stay maybe 2 months and 3 months, and after that there will be a stabilization phase. When that phase happens, we cannot be dependent on these events. So while news will play a big role of whatever we have gone through, but it needs to keep up that momentum in engaging the consumer. And as long as they're doing that and there's viewership coming, advertisers will definitely be there. I mean, what are they seeking? They're seeking consumers' eyeball end of the day.
But Vishali, if I can interrupt. So if you go by numbers, viewership has never been a problem with news channels. They've always got viewership. But yet they've never got the kind of prize they have wanted, you know. All throughout, like, we had Lok Sabha elections, we had state elections, there was Ayodhya verdict, there was so much happening. So, I mean, you can correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think viewership is, engagement is a problem. Still, they're not able to convert it into numbers.
I'm not agreeing to this, because when there was Lok Sabha election, for example, we've paid prices which is like 10 times higher than what we would have normally paid. So on event which is a pre-decided event, and you know that they, or a budget, for example, right? Or IPL, during IPL times or World Cup times, you know that the viewership will be driven towards news channel. There is a differential pricing, and advertisers have gone ahead and paid that prices, because you know you are getting that viewership or eyeballs or ROI. But the second point is also that news as a genre is very fragmented, you know. So while the genre is so earlier, if I'm not wrong, news would contribute say 7 to 8% to the entire TV ad revenue, but today it could be 20%. But what happens is there are 400 news channels. And of course, I'm counting all the regionals per se. So what happens is, even within Hindi, if there are like 10 news channels, there will always be, a vying for who gets the maximum share. And then what happens is it commoditizes the advertising volume, you know. So as media planners, when you're sitting and making media plans, you cannot have 10 channels in a plan. So you kind of you play your bet on the top four or the next four kind of a thing, and it's never possible to advertise in the entire genre. So I think somewhere, I mean, I don't know whether I'm right in saying that, but it needs a consolidation. We have not seen so many channels in any other genre. So somewhere I feel that it needs maybe a consolidation. I mean, some of the people might not like this, but I'm just talking now, wearing my hat as a media professional, that it needs consolidation so that each of the news bucket or the channel gets their due share.
So another expert that I was speaking to last week, fragmentation, of course, everyone has said that that is the biggest problem with news genre. Yes. Also said that there's too much focus on competing with each other and pulling each other down instead of, you know, focusing on their own product. Do you agree with that?
Yeah, I agree. And, you know, let me draw a parallel here with, say, a newspaper. Now we still go back and read the newspaper and we know the news, but we still read the newspaper. There's a lot of focus on the editorial content, you know, and I've always failed to believe that. Why don't news channel behave the same way? Editorial is the ability to not only deliver the news, but deliver the implication arising out of the news. You know, what's in for us, what's in for you, from multiple perspectives, and people are seeking that, but that doesn't happen. But the news channels are vying for, as I said in my you know, earlier answer, that who broke the news first. So there's so much of focus on speed, and there's so much of focus on getting that viewership or GRPs that will follow. I have always believed that focus on your input, focus on what are the right metrics to touch, the output will happen automatically. You know, that will reflect in the viewership. And while I can't name some of the news channels, but I have seen some of the news channels, how they're using technology, how they're using various measures in terms of, creating their content, which is more magazine format, which is more opinion led, which is more views led. And I can see a difference, you know, whenever we are analyzing from a viewership perspective. I've seen that those work. And and I also want to add, there are a lot of news aggregators, for example, also are coming up, you know, in the digital space, for example, like a Daily Hunt or InShot. And why do they exist? You know, they should not exist ideally, because if news channel independently do that job well, then we don't need those aggregators. So somewhere I'm sure there is something which is missing. They're doing a great job, and I'm sure there are some nuggets to be fixed, which is the only, missing link, as I would want to call, in terms of, you know, for them to get back to what they truly can command. And if they create value, they will definitely get value.
Another thing I would want to understand from you is that for GEC, the biggest problem right now is they're not able to create fresh content because all the production houses are shut. So even if when the lockdown is over or there are relaxations, it will take them time to, you know, go back to normal, wherein news channel has already got that momentum. So how long do you think this golden phase of news channels being on, and considering that when the markets will start opening, like some states have already started relaxing the norms, minus Mumbai or other places.
Yeah. Yeah,
the addicts will also see a significant rise. I mean, things will start getting better and better for news channels in coming days.
I think definitely. So we are in the middle of, and I think everybody around us, right, we're trying to predict and work on multiple scenarios. So for example, if a lot of government have decided on getting their workforce back with almost 33%, that will lead to some viewership impact, right? So overall time spent on television has gone up, but it will not be a sustainable, I mean, I'm sure it will stabilize. But news in particular, as you rightly said, will be here to stay for long, given that, you know, and whatever we all keep reading, that this virus will become a part of our lives. It's not something that it will just one fine morning we get up and we become virus free. We are not going to see that situation, right? And hence the need for news channel again to shoulder that, to guide the consumers, to get the right insight, and with the use of technology again to navigate, you know, how should one go about it and give the first hand views. And as long as they continue to do so, I see them definitely being part of, you know, at the overall scheme of things for this year. They have a long, and they should not think short term. You know, they should focus on their long-term strategy. And it's similar to how we are telling this to our brands, right? We are telling most of the brands that, you know, you need to take a responsibility, be reliable, be accessible, you know, and that's what the consumers will bank on. So if you are salient, you are honest, and that's what, you know, consumers are seeking. The same analogy applies to the new genre as well. So they are definitely have a window. They have definitely have a long window. Even if GEC's fresh content comes back, I mean, I still see 2 months down the line, most of the shooting happens or the studio are in Bombay, and Bombay is severely affected. But even if they revive, say, sometime around July, there will be some kind of erosion which new genre will see for sure. But I think they have reached a certain peak. They can definitely sustain it, not to the pre-COVID times, but somewhere in the middle, which I'm calling it as a stabilization phase. So I see a positive thing there.
So I would want to understand from you what measures can they take to sustain it. But before you answer, I want more people to start putting their questions. We only have 15 more minutes of Vaishali's time. And so please, whosoever is live right now must put questions. And you can tag E4M, hashtag E4M webinar and hashtag ABP news. Please start putting your questions before Vaishali's time is up and she has too many things on her hand to do. So you only have the last 10-15 minutes to ask her questions. So coming back to the question I asked from you is that, what do you think can be a long-term strategy for them?
See, the long-term strategy, again, I think I mentioned it, that they should not focus on only key events. Like PM speech, of course, is a big event. You know, yesterday, 8 p.m., lot of advertisers or lot of our ongoing advertisers reached out, right, that they wanted some kind of a presence. But why only during that time, you know? So there is the news channels are offering a lot of content beyond that. And I think most of, if I'm not wrong, a lot of the FMCG guys or a lot of the other sectors who were not taking new genre as seriously or were not part of their plan have seen that shift, right? So of course, a lot has come at the back of GEC, but they have shifted. Now, if they have shifted and they're advertising there, as long as they see the momentum in viewership going on, they will stick there. How does news channel deliver that? Again, I'm not an expert to comment, but as I said earlier, that if they develop a strong editorial content, you know, on views, opinion, which viewers or consumers value, and their answers or their questions get answered, they see value in that, that definitely will work in keeping that, you know, momentum on. So not so much, don't focus so much on breaking news. Don't focus so much on, you know, 8 p.m. news and 9 p.m. news. You know, get the experts, get expert opinions, do some magazine format. I know, again, easy to say, but think of content which you have the consumer coming onto your channel. Think of content which keeps them engaged on your
channel. But a lot of them are doing it. No, they've started giving out entertainment stories also. Yeah. They are trying to experiment for a very, very long time because even they have too much competition.
Yeah, and the real test happens, you know, when the general, when the original content comes back, you know, when the original content comes back, it should not erode the viewership. And hence, I'm strongly believing that given so much newsiness which is around us, news has a strong, you know, lever to tap on because this whole year will be very newsy on how the situation unfolds and even at a state level, et cetera, or at, even at a region level or a district level. And hence news, you know, genre has a strong foreplay there. So as long as they are able to capitalize it, they will have consumers hooked on. Once they have consumers hooked on, advertisers will follow. you know, they will definitely
would you like to give us some estimate, you know, how much increase in price can you expect by end of this year?
That's also linked to demand and supply, you know. I mean, media market is very much like a stock market, you know, so it's a demand supply. So while I think I started by saying that while the viewership has grown, it has not resulted in the proportionate.
No, not talking about current times, but okay, you know, another after a few months when the adex is better, and but the other channels are still in the phase of recovering, and this channel is already, because this has not gone off, right? So this is already on. So what kind of growth can we expect in that period?
I think if I'm not wrong, currently it's almost at a, I'm not talking from a viewership growth or an, I'm talking more from an advertising revenue growth. Currently, I think it's almost at about 20-21% growth, not contribution, the growth. I mean, that's a, it's a blip. So a best estimate, even if, you know, post-COVID situation, if they continue with, you know, at a stabilized eyeballs, if I may say, it might not have a 200% growth. But what if they kind of stabilize at even a 50% growth or a 40% growth? It will not be 200. Then definitely, why not? They will definitely see an increase in, you know, pricing. And so I would not quote a number on the pricing increase because all my investment leads are going to come heavy on me. But again, let me say that it's all ROI. And it's all return on investment. If the eyeballs are there, advertisers will pay. Today, there is a certain softness in the market at the back of demand being low. And hence, maybe they are not getting that due because, you know, a lot of sectors are not advertising. So there is still inventory available. But once all sectors bounce back and there is demand and there is a certain viewership increase, that definitely will lead to a price increase as well.
I'm glad at least some industry will show some growth, positive growth this year.
We are hopeful. We are absolutely hopeful that a few sectors should start opening. And
Vaishali, we already have some sure. questions coming up for you. Sanket Rastogi wants to know, how soon will see the sales picking up once the lockdown is lifted? It's more of a generic question, not only related to news.
Yeah, see, that might take a bit long because as we know that sales has got hit at the back of supply chain, you know, the retail shutdown, etc. So that I would say will take a long, and it depends on the sectors to sectors. So a lot of CPG or FMCG, which is into essentials, they have not seen that kind of, you know, hit. But if you're talking about sectors like fashion or sectors like consumer good, I mean, they might come back. I mean, of course, there'll be some pent-up demand, which typically happens whenever, you know, the lockdown will get over. There'll be a pent-up demand for luxury, for beauty, for fashion. But as I see, not before festive. You know, festive is one time when we are all banking on that will be a revival of, you know, our lost times. But I don't see, you know, things stabilizing before that for a lot of these sectors, which I just called out.
So there's another interesting question. The person has not given his name. Would you want to throw some light on FMCG strategy on news, henceforth at the cost of GEC?
FMCG, as I was saying, they're in the business of reaching consumer every day. And hence, they need to be on air almost, you know, 52 weeks in a year. So they look for wherever the eyeballs are or wherever the GRPs are. So, you know, their strategy will obviously change a bit once there's a revival of GEC, which starts to happen. But we have seen strong shift towards news genre. I would not say that everything will get eroded. Definitely, there'll be some erosion which will happen back to, you know, what the viewership, but it will mirror the viewership. And as long as news genre are contributing substantially, they have a strong chance to be part of their advertising pie.
There's one another interesting question asked by Mr. Sandeep Srivastav. Given such a spike in viewership in news genre, I would expect some of the increase to stay in the post-COVID phase too. Do you think brands will benefit more from a longer term relevant association with properties that tie in with brand message than making an opportunistic use as what we see currently?
Definitely, and consumers will make more rational choices, right, going forward, and they will start to be very conscious of their spends, and brands will need to adapt to that, and the focus will shift to brand. Today we talk about brand love and all that, and I see that shifting towards brand value, and hence there's a big opportunity to deliver that in an interesting contextual way with a lot of content which resides. So to make it more contextual, to make it more topical, there is huge opportunity. In fact, we are working for one of our education, online education clients on creating a lot of these interesting, content formats with new genre. So definitely, yes.
There's another gentleman who wants to know, how about the numbers? No, she's a girl. Resham wants to know, if yes, then how the news? No, sorry. I'm mixing up two questions. What do you feel about the women worship? Have the numbers gone up for the new all news channels?
The numbers have gone up across demographics. So the numbers have gone up across demographic, and as you know, most of the Hindi heartland or most of the India has single TV homes. So that, and it has become part of the family viewership, right? The family sitting together and watching. We've seen spikes on Ramayana, Mahabharat. We've seen spikes on, news. So definitely, it's part of the over increase for women. And if it would not be, then you would not have most of your FMCG brands advertising, because they typically target women audiences, right? So the P&G or RB or Unilever, etc. So we see a lot of shift in advertising happening from them. So it definitely mirrors increase in women viewership.
Shobhit Arora has in fact asked something that we completely missed out on. Is business news genre also showing similar amount of growth? What are the views about business?
Yeah, I mean, I don't remember the number, but I think business news channel has also seen at about 120% growth, if I'm not wrong, because people are keen. There is a lot of anxiety, around how the economy is going and, which are the sectors which will bounce back. So there is some growth there as well. And if I'm not wrong, the number is about 120. In the male audiences, I remember seeing the number of almost 180%. So which is substantial, though it is a lower base. And lot of, when the sectors get revived, when the consumer goods or automobile, etc., they get revived, they will definitely be, business news genre will be one of the key genre for them.
There's another anonymous attendee who wants to know, would you see a media mix change on TV plan post-COVID?
Media mix, so I'm just reiterating, if I've understood the question, media mix means television, digital, print, and the breakup of that. Or your question is only on...
Speaking only about television, I think.
Only on television. It will mirror the viewership. Today, we've seen the increase in a movie as a genre. We've seen increase in news. So more of the advertising has shifted towards, the movie as a genre, movie and news followed by GEC. So it will mirror where the viewership goes. If the viewership sustains the way it is, definitely it will see a change. Media is dynamic, right? We all live in such a dynamic scenario. We are currently, operating on a weekly basis. So we don't even know how June will be. So things are fairly dynamic. And I think we need to keep our ears close to the ground and keep making changes and keep evolving as you see the landscape evolve.
I'll take one last question before we close. Rohit Mohan wants to know, do you think that the shift of TV news from reporter-based stories to studio-based shows have led to a decline in credibility or TV news vis-a-vis newspaper? I think you sort of spoke about it when you said there should be more editorial content, right?
Yeah. I was just trying to draw a parallel from newspaper. I mean, I don't have data to say that what has led and what kind of content has led. I think it's every news channel needs to be a mix of all kind of content. There needs to be citizen journalism. There needs to be studio shows. There needs to be strong views. My bigger point was, if we have to create a parallel of an editorial of what typically newspaper do, I see a big scope there, and I see a big leap there where a news channel could take that.
We have 1 minute left. If you allow me, I can take one more question.
Sure, Nazia, go ahead.
So, because I think this is an interesting question. Would you think frequency will be more important than unique reach for small indigenous brands on TV, thus build news health?
Today, news has grown so much that it's helping in reach as well, right? It's the second biggest genre, so it's giving you reach as well. Traditionally, we've always used news as a frequency builder, barring the special events. But I don't know which sector you mean by, you are referring to, but if you're talking about, SMB sectors or small, medium thing, then sure. If we are targeting a small set of consumer, then frequency becomes important. But when you're targeting, a large scale or a bigger set, then you need reach. So as long as reach or frequency depends upon what your audience base is. But I'm assuming that you're talking about a small audience base. And if that's so, then sure, frequency makes sense.
So we are almost out of time now, and it was kind of Vishali to take that last question despite we being already out of time. So before I sum up, I think what Vishali has tried to say is that, of course, news is going through a very positive golden phase, and it should, if it work on a couple of things like bringing in more credibility and bringing in, correct me if I'm wrong, if I'm just trying to sum up what I've understood from you, and focus more on sustainable content instead of banking too much on, that momentary things that keep coming in, it can benefit more in terms of ROI and ADEX, wherein it make a more planned content instead of just focusing on breaking news which just comes in. Am I right, Vishali?
Yeah, absolutely.
So, and if it does so, this is definitely going to be a very good year for news, which is already which has already seen an unprecedented hike of 200-300%. And as the industry opens, as the lockdown opens, it can definitely see a 50% or 60% hike in its ad rates also, if it continues to get the similar amount of viewership. So we'll be back next week with another edition of News is Undervalued, which is brought to you in association with ABP News. We'll be back with another very senior industry person. For this week, we want to thank Vishali for her time, and thank you so much for all the insight that you have given to us. We couldn't take up some questions, but we'll try to accommodate them next time. Thank you very much, Vishali.
Thanks, Nazia. Thank you so much. Thanks, everybody.
Bye.